was just thinking about the Colonel. I'll be the first to admit that he's quite the specimen of a man. But... Welcome back, my loyal subjects, to more Trails in the Sky. Pharaoh Fiasco here. Last time, we... got Olivier. That's pretty much the biggest thing of note to happen. We finally have four party members. I'm actually going to check to see if any new requests have become available since getting him, but first... we gotta take care of this. See, I was trying to avoid this, but I realized I can probably just set up annotations or something that'll point people in the right direction. But I do plan on reading the entirety of Carnelia on camera. I mean, it's just... I mean, it's more entertaining that way, I think. But we're not gonna do that right this second, because we had a little bit of mirror to burn, just a tad bit. I can't even remember the last time we upgraded anybody's anything. Wait. And I'm gonna have to start making a lot more use of walking now, because with three people, it was impossible. And with four people, we're pretty much gonna be a battle magnet if we're running around all over the place. Oh, stolen ring. I already checked this. Let's see. Stolen ring. Oh, that's wrong. I was burglarized. Bose's south block. Okay. So we head over to Bose's south block, which is where? There we go. Thank you, start button. And now we just have to... oh! This is new! Royal Army Soldier! I can't believe these Sky Bandits managed to circumvent our search and just walked right into town and burglarized a bunch of places. We were really outdone this time. I mean, yeah, maybe if you guys were cooperating more closely with Bracers, that wouldn't have happened. Oh, I guess they're stationed here now, huh? Well, you know what they say, too little too freaking late. Oh, this is probably her. I'm not trying to be rude, but this is an official investigation. Move it along. Huh, can we not talk to her? What the actual heck? I guess... dang, so it must not be her then. I was shocked when I heard about the South Block being hit by burglars. Morano's mother was here alone, you see. Fortunately, this house was untouched in the burglaries, so it's not her either. But it's at times like this when that it makes you feel uneasy when there's no man at home. I'm just glad that Morano brought Simon over to watch the house. True, it's not 2016 yet, so I guess women still need a man to watch the house for them. C'est la vie. What about you, Morano? Now we've got burglars running amok in the city? I swear, what's happening to Bose? I'm just glad they left this house alone, though I'm baffled as to why. They certainly didn't do their homework on this city. I mean, maybe there's nothing but trash stuff in here, and trash people. You ever think about that? Hmm. Am I still in the South Block? No, I'm in the... yeah, I'm still in the South Block. I just came out a different way. Hmm. This must be it. We'll be done with our questioning here soon, so how about sitting tight until we finish? Crap, dude, we can't talk to anybody? Lana. She lives in a house on the South Block. I mean, I guess I've already got the quest initiated, but... don't I have to... I honestly, there's no indication to me of where I can find this ring. It's quite valuable to me. What houses have we not checked? There's that one over here, I think. There we go. Oh no, Niall and Dorothy. What the heck?
Yay, this one turned out really cute.
Niall, is this how you wanted this one?
Yeah, sure, something like that. However, we really got screwed, you know that?
Good afternoon. Are you working on another story?
Looks like you two are on the trail of a scoop again.
Hey, it's you kids!
Oh, Estelle and Joshua!
Boy, am I glad to see that they let you out of the clinker!
Yeah, I heard all about you kids getting arrested by the army up at the old mine. You certainly had me worried.
Why are you acting like you had nothing to do with it?
It was your info that led us to the village!
Hey now, what kind of face is that? Don't tell me you blame us.
Did you go and check out the abandoned mine yourselves?
Yeah, we did yesterday. But it was after you all had already been hauled off.
We could have had a really great shot of your arrest had we been there. It really guts me that we missed such a perfect opportunity for a great shot.
Yeah, I'm glad that's all you missed.
I swear, you people in the news business...
But anyway, I was wondering if you thought this looked like the handiwork of the Sky Bandits.
It sure looks that way to me.
It seems that the army is sniffing around for clues too. But to be honest, it looks like there's nothing to be found here anymore.
I see. That does make things a bit more difficult.
Well, Mr. Reporter, why don't you let me ask you this then? Did you know from whence the Sky Bandits entered town?
According to witness statements, they were seen leaving through the west gate.
Well, that's awfully strange. The mayor's residence and Bose Market are right through the west gate. And it seems like attacking those two places would be far more lucrative.
When you put it that way, that makes a lot of sense. But if you don't mind me asking, who the heck are you anyway?
I'm glad you asked. I'm Olivier Lenham, a wandering bard and gifted musician. I'm sure you've heard rumors about me, right?
Oh, right! You're the guy who drank wine without paying at that classy restaurant! It takes guts to stiff such a big bill! It's an honor to meet you, sir!
You're making me blush. I'm ready for my interview anytime, so don't hesitate to ask.
Wow, really?
I'm getting a headache just listening to this crap.
These two are very much alike. I'm not even going to ask how this guy wound up with the rest of you.
That would be for the best.
Okay, so are you Lana, though?
Carrie. Wow, it looks like the burglars made off with nearly everything. I could have sworn that my boss locked up last night.
If your bosses are Niall and Dorothy, they probably did not.
Oh, they're above the Orbal factory. Who knew? Marco, it looks like this store was hit by the burglars as well. I guess this isn't the time to be talking about business deals.
So we can't buy anything from him?
My factory! My factory and all my goods, they're gone! I've got to report this to either the army or the Bracer Guild ASAP! Now hold on just a minute. If either one of those groups saw what was written in that stolen ledger...
Yikes, I'd be in for a world of hurt!
So, you're cooking the books then, huh?
It doesn't seem to have affected the quartz that we can buy from him. I've got time to cast Artist's Cut. Blinds enemies with 10% success. I've got 3 EP cuts? Move 1. Honestly, Joshua could use a move 1.
So apparently when I was fighting, and I, like a dummy, I didn't even realize, but when I was fighting the Master Kryon, they activate, oh, Niles and Dorothy are gone, but Deathblow 2 procs when you attack physically, and I'd had Joshua physically attack one of the boiled eggers and didn't realize that I instantly killed it. So that was me just being a huge idiot that whole fight. Oh well.
What the heck?
So, at this point, I'm feeling like we actually can't even talk to Lana. We just have to, like...
there's probably still some important information we haven't gathered. We should continue to ask around a bit longer and see what we come up with.
So there's something story-wise I have to see here.
I was just in here, wasn't I?
Yep.
And then this is the Orbal Factory.
Oh! Hey, you there!
What? Is something wrong?
I thought I'd better give you a word of advice. Even if you are representing the mayor, at the end of the day, you're all still civilians.
Okay, so there's no distinction between civilian and bracer like there is between civilian and army officer or army personnel.
We cannot have you wandering around here in the middle of our investigation.
Who do you think you're talking to?
Your advice seems rather more like a threat.
I'm just saying you need to know your place. But if you're so adamant about investigating the matter, then do it after we've cleared out of here. If we get any more trouble out of you, then I'm going to have to give you a personal invitation to jail.
Forget about it, Estelle. There's no use arguing with these gentlemen.
Ha! For an ass in lion skin, you sure know how to throw your weight around, Mr. Soldier.
What did you just say?
May I ask what's going on here?
New character?
Yeah.
These freaking jokes. Colonel! This must be that Richard guy!
For a soldier in the prestigious Royal Army to be threatening our good civilians. That is an outright embarrassment to us all.
But these aren't just civilians, sir. They're members of the Bracer Guild.
Oh, is that so? Then I ask you once again, what is going on here?
The army is supposed to be working closely with the guild.
What do you intend to accomplish by being rude to our allies?
But as far as the general is concerned...
Yes, that side of the general really concerns me. I'll take over the investigation from here, so please take your men and clear out.
But sir...
Your men have been here since early this morning, so I presume that a sufficient investigation has been conducted by now, yes? I'll smooth things over with the general later.
Is there anything else you wish me to address?
No, sir.
Alright, men, pack it up. We're returning to Hawken Gate.
Yeah, skedaddle, boyos!
It looks like that's that. It seems that some of our personnel were rather impolite. Please allow me to apologize.
I appreciate the gesture.
But we made some slightly inflammatory remarks as well, so how about we let bygones be bygones?
That suits me just fine.
As I stated before, the army is supposed to be working closely with the guild. I think our two organizations working together grants us each the ability to make up for the other's shortcomings. I'm looking forward to any progress you make with this recent series of events.
We'll do our best not to disappoint you.
He seems like a decent guy.
Yeah, I wonder who he is.
It's weird he hasn't been falling over himself to introduce himself to us like they usually do.
Colonel, it's almost the appointed time.
Oh, already? Excuse me, but it appears I must take my leave.
Oh, but before I do, it looks like I haven't properly introduced myself.
I am Alan Richard, a colonel in the Royal Army. If there is anything I can do to assist you, please don't hesitate to contact me.
So that was Colonel Richard.
He doesn't look... I think someone made a comment as far as him being super young. He looks about Sherazard and Olivier's age.
Colonel Richard? I feel like I've heard that name somewhere before.
Yeah, it was like 2 or 3 episodes back.
Niall was the one who mentioned his name earlier. He said something about him being a sharp young officer who leads the Royal Army's intelligence division.
Ah, so he's their Lecter counterpart. And so that pink-haired woman must have been their Claire.
Oh, right. Wow, for someone in the military, he sure knows how to listen to others.
Probably in his mid-30s, and he's not hard on the eyes either. He seems like he's more fit to be a politician than a service member in the army.
Hey, you guys!
Oh, Niall.
Who was that you were just talking to in the black uniform?
I could swear I've seen him somewhere before.
Are you trying to tell me you didn't recognize him at all? That was Colonel Richard of the Intelligence Division. You know, the guy you mentioned earlier.
What? You're not pulling my leg, are you?
As fun as that would be, no.
He said so himself, so I'm barely confident he is who he says he is.
To think that the legend himself would show up here. We can't wait around like this any longer, Dorothy. Let's see if we can catch up to him.
Aye, aye, sir. Although I'm really not sure why we're chasing after anyone.
Did you see his eyes light up? I wonder if he's going to do an interview or something.
Anyone else in the army would brush him off, but I'm sure the colonel will oblige him.
Oh, Olivier seems pensive about something?
What's the matter with you, Olivier? You look serious.
And I gotta say, I find it creepy coming from you. He's probably insulted that they want an interview with the colonel rather than him.
I was just thinking about the colonel. I'll be the first to admit that he's quite the specimen of a man. But what?
I can say with confidence that he doesn't stand a chance against me when it comes to the ladies. But I'd like to see him try just a little harder. It's no fun without a romantic rival.
You just had to ask, didn't you, Joshua?
I'll regret it for the rest of my life.
Alright, let's see here. Now that the soldiers are gone, how about we resume our own investigation? Let's start by talking to all of the people we couldn't talk to earlier.
Good idea.
Alright, and right before we do our investigation, let's read that Cornelius pit a bit. Books. There we go. And see, you can actually open it up by clicking on the book this time, rather than having to go into your notes. Wait, okay, yeah. Cornelia, chapter 1.
I stood there upright in front of the revolving door, scuffing the heels of my boots against the ground. Pulling slightly on the collar of my trench coat, I dropped my chin and gazed at my partial reflection in the curved glass. Aside from my short cropped hair, I wore a modest looking double breasted leather raincoat and a pair of special order steel reinforced boots, both of which at first glance appeared to be the most common of common apparel.
Oh, okay, I have to press X or A.
Yet they were in fact much more than the naked eye could detect. My ordinary average appearance, it was of just as much importance today as it had been on any other day in the past. Not far off, the sound of footfalls echoed rhythmically like the steady beat of a pendulum swinging back and forth as the throngs of those coming and going moved quickly along the cobblestone avenue, enveloped in tinged silver by the morning mist. At times, the calling voice of a street peddler disrupted the steady flow, but as soon as the hawking cry faded away, it would resume its course. Each morning that I found myself setting foot in the Imperial City, I also found my surroundings to be unchanged and stained by the same somber tone of gray. Snatching up a magazine from the underarm of a street vendor, I tossed a few mirrors to the left hand poised expectantly behind his back. The Imperial Chronicle, the magazine I read so often that even the ink bleeds were familiar. Roughly flipping over its cover, I scanned the headlines along the top of its monochrome pages. Then suddenly, my breath caught in my throat. At the very bottom of the local news page, I found those letters, that sequence of characters which I had not heard nor seen since the time of that life-changing incident. My eyes instantly gravitated to the spot, and for a time remained fixated. Einselnate. The very meaning of those letters became lost to my senses as I stood motionless, my gaze fixed on the same line of text, until it all seemed to coalesce into a single blotch of ink. After a few seconds of blank comprehension, my vision settled and I wrenched my eyes to the beginning of the article. As I began to read, my memories verged onto a single point in my past, and then slowly started to run in reverse, heading for that fateful event 3 years prior when this name was first introduced to me. It was on an afternoon all those years ago, on a day not unlike this one, where the capital was overshadowed by its typical gloomy aura. I was a little younger than now, a 22-year-old boy who stood silently in front of the boutique door as usual, double-checking his appearance before lightly treading over to Mixed's Orbital Imperial Factory. Mixed?
Mixed's or Imperial Orbal Factory. We've been there, but I don't think... Was that in Relent? Mixed's Imperial Orbal Factory. I don't think that was in Relent. I think that was in Trails of Cold Steel, but... Oh my god. For the life of me, I can't remember. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say we've been to Mixed's Imperial Orbal Factory, but it was in Trails of Cold Steel somewhere, rather than this game. It was on this day that it had been arranged for me to receive a new job for Mixed, the shop owner himself. Although he was a drab, middle-aged man, I, being the Orban enthusiast I was, had found myself as one of his few regular customers. I headed down a dank alleyway, and after passing through a partially rotted wooden gate, I could see the soft glow of the flickering orbal light just outside the entrance of the factory, whose structure was halfway below street level. Yeah, this is in Trista! I first began receiving jobs from Mixed about the time when dissension began to occur in society over the Hundred Days War. It was during this period the relations between the Liberal Kingdom and the Empire were at their worst, and the importation of Orbans had become almost non-existent. Conspiring with underground elements and planning a smuggling operation, Mixed made me out to be his accomplice in crime. For the job which I had received by his hand was none other than that of the courier. Being nothing more than a commoner in my teens at the time, I met him and a juvie devoid of any connections in life besides, I naturally jumped at the opportunity without a moment's hesitation. Yet, even after the relations with Liberal had returned to some degree of normalcy, I realized I was in no mood to give up my specialty, which focused mainly on the delivery of stolen goods. The reason being, there was no job out there which should bring in the kind of mira this one did. With an unrefined and inconspicuous appearance, I had countless times before hidden items of various sorts in my hat and trousers and made my way hither and thither between the borders of these neighboring nations. He's a smuggler, jeez! And although to my delight, my wallet had become increasingly laden with a bounty of monetary rewards, I'd routinely changed my alias as a precautionary measure. So much, in fact, that these false names had built up into quite a list over the last few years. I had been known as Phil the Frivolous, Rooney the Trickster, and even Chris the Coward. However, Mixed had always called me by one name, Toby. This was the identity I'd used for my initial job, and the one I liked above all the others. So Ein Selnate might just be a pseudonym? But I could have sworn Ein Selnate was a woman. Ein Selnate is probably someone completely different. I'm not gonna read the second chapter in this episode, but we'll find out more about that later on. Cecile, oh dear me. Weren't you the bracers who came to ask questions not that long ago? Oh, right, we did come before. I'm really sorry I couldn't talk to you then. So what you came to ask about is what happened last night, right?
Yes, that's right. Is this a good time for you?
Yeah, this is as good a time as any. It was the middle of the night, you see, when I heard a noise coming from outside. And I, of course, thought that it was my husband coming home at such a late hour, so I opened the door and started yelling. But it turned out to be a group of masked men coming out of the Orbal Factory across the road. I thought my heart was gonna plumb stop right then and there. Although, it turned out the burglars were rather surprised and ran away to the north. Oh, so she never even got burgled. I see. So it was the Sky Bandits, huh?
So, what you're saying, then, is that this house didn't incur a loss of any kind.
Yeah, thanks to the mercy of the goddess. Can I ask you another thing? Did your husband come home late mean that he went to the bar? If it was only that, then that would be forgivable.
In addition to being a no-good drinker, he's obsessed with this.
Cecile raised her hand in a casting motion. Orbments?
Huh?
Oh, I get it. You mean fishing, right?
Oh, casting a fishing line. I see now.
That's right, he loves fishing more than life itself. Just yesterday, he said something about catching some smelt and took off to the lake in the south. And on top of that, he still hasn't come back.
Oh, that's not good.
So what you're saying is, he doesn't know anything about the incident? That's exactly what I'm saying. And when that good-for-nothing husband of mine gets home, he's going to get what for, let me tell you. Hi, honey, I'm home. Ooh, what a day I had. I was fishing patiently all morning, but I have nothing to show for it.
Oh no, dude, you couldn't come home empty-handed. Not to me, bro.
Oh, what's this? Do we have house guests?
You senile old man!
My goodness, woman, what kind of fiery tempest has gotten into you? Don't you know it's rude to act like that in front of guests?
If anyone's being rude, that would be you. I'm dumbfounded my own husband can just take off to do what he likes at a time like this.
Huh? What do you mean by at a time like this?
Maybe I should explain.
Joshua gave Mr. Kuano a brief explanation regarding the burglaries which transpired the previous night.
Burglaries by sky bandits? You don't say.
Now that is terrible.
But to think that they hightailed it out of here after my wife hollered at them is hilarious. Guess they got to experience the Cecile effect firsthand.
What did you just say?
Let's all calm down now, shall we?
But to think that these sky bandits came in the night like they did and then just disappeared like that. I wonder if it has anything to do with that thing he was talking about the other day.
What do you mean?
Oh, right. You don't know him. He is my fishing buddy. He's staying at the inn down the lakeshore to the south of here. If I remember right, he said something about seeing a strange bunch near the place the other night.
A strange bunch?
So he's at Valeria Lakeshore.
Now this sounds really interesting.
Can you tell us more about what you've heard?
Sure, I don't mind, but I'm just going to tell you up front that this is all hearsay. From what I heard, he just happened to see them by chance as he was out fishing during the night. He saw them leave by way of the inn's front door and then out onto the road. However, when he asked around at the inn in the morning, it turned out that no one like that had stayed there the night before.
Yeah, that is rather odd. So, was there any type of burglary at the inn?
No, nothing of the sort at all, in fact. It's quiet there. The meals are great and it's, well, a place I'd recommend to anyone. But best of all, it's a prime fishing spot.
Though there weren't any definitive clues related to the incident, we did manage to hear a few interesting bits.
I concur. I especially like the one that described all the delicious food at the inn.
That's not what we're talking about here! Although I did find the fishing part to be rather interesting. Unfortunately, if there's nothing going on there, then I guess it wouldn't be worth investigating.
Actually, I think it's quite the opposite. If someone has been careless and caused a problem, the army would have thoroughly investigated it. Conversely, the possibility of the sky bandits appearing where there's nothing happening is rather high.
Oh, well, I guess that's one way to think about it.
And in light of this series of incidents, there's either a spy in the army or the sky bandits are a really clever bunch of thieves. It'll be extremely difficult to corner them only by investigating the incidents which have occurred. We'll need to get one step ahead of them by tracking their movements.
I see. So what you're saying is that we should take an offensive stance rather than a defensive one.
Then how about we get going?
Off to the beautiful Valeria Lake, extolled in many a rhyme as the Pearl of the Burl.
Huh. First. God dang it, there we go. I want to save. Just to be safe. And let's keep going, because we still have to find Lana.
Yeah, he's decked out pretty well. Who's seriously in need of an upgrade?
No one just yet.
Alright. Ooh, wrong. That was super extra wrong. Freaking Lana. That's them. Just came out of this house.
I don't think I've talked to anyone named Lana up until this point.
Oh, this is still them! Oh my... Adios! Modena. I know my husband is always out and about, but not having him around makes me feel a little insecure. Please, come home safely. Oh, and Murano's not there anymore. What about here? Are you Lana? Rion. I really hope this city will settle down soon. The stock market's cooling down, and at this rate I'm going to show a big deficit this month on my financial report. And just when I had beaten out the Trinos last month too. None of them are Lana. Who the heck is Lana? Let's try up here? Nope, this is the Orbal Factory. And I think I could speak to the people in here. Lana! I had a very important ring taken by them. I don't care if it's the army or the Bracer Guild, I just want to see those burglars caught! If these Sky Bandits are on the loose, I don't think I can live without being in fear every day. Okay. So that's that. I guess if she's been burgled, the only thing left we can do is go down to Valeria Lakeshore. Ooh, god dang it! Sentis stench. Oh, miss! Get out of here, dude! So, we're doing 132 damage. Oh, he's confused. Not gonna be too much use. Boom, baby. 51! Ooh, that's not good. And then Olivia gets the last hit. If he'd missed, I'd have been highly upset. He gets double turns? What? Okay, whatever. Oh, wow. Boom. Ooh. Oh, she can't attack. She can, however, use airstrike. Actually, what are you using? Firebolt. Sure. Let's have him use an art. You're freaking dead. All right. He's level 15, so he gained 2 levels between now and when we had him last. Just 1 curative horn. And this should be the right way to Valeria Lakeshore. Yep. Just 1 more bend and then we should be there. Or no, there were 2 screens actually. Okay. This one branches off into the Amberl Tower. Oh! I could make a detour up there right now, actually. First, we gotta kill this thing, though. What the heck? Okay. Freaking office, dude. No one cares about office. Alright. Let me make sure I'm... Yeah, I should be good. We should be good. Fire, right. And then Charizard will use Petrify Breath, why not? A Firebolt from you. And then Joshua can hopefully get Soul Blur going. Crap. Oh well, he's not gonna last too much longer. Especially now that we've got 4 party members. This is gonna be a cakewalk. Get some. And you're petrified. Oh, it's over.
Enjoy the show.
Fire Sepith. And HP 2. Awesome. Let's actually take a look at what everybody's using for their ornaments. It's already got an HP 2. Impede 1, Shield 1, Petrify. He's already got an HP 2 as well. His ordinance is actually almost completely open. I wonder... So I was thinking, like, as far as this goes, I'm playing on hard, but this game, the Steam version released, like, forever, probably, like, 8 years or so. Ooh, Valeria Lakeshore. Like, 8 years after the original one. So, hard difficulty, it's probably intended for people who beat Trails in the Sky initially and wanted a brand spanking new version of the challenge, rather than someone who's pretty much jumping in fresh for the first time. Not to say that I'm gonna stop playing on hard, but I was just thinking about that.
So this is the north shore of Valeria Lake, huh? It certainly seems peaceful and quiet around here.
The inn doesn't look too shabby either.
I stayed here once before when I was in the area on another job.
The wine's great, the rooms are nice, pretty much what you'd expect from a place like this.
Too bad this isn't a pleasure trip.
You mean it's not? I at least intend to toss my cares to the wind for a while.
Taking catnaps on a rocking boat by day and filling my belly with food and wine by night. Heaven. This is what a vacation is all about.
Come on, everyone, I was just joking.
We can enjoy a vacation anytime, but now is the only time we can enjoy taking care of some would-be thieves. Even I, Olivier Lenham, would know enough to get my priorities straight.
I don't think this has anything to do with enjoyment or not.
Very well, whatever. As long as he does his share of the work he's here to do. Let's see if we can find the old man staying here that loves fishing.
The guest who said he saw some suspicious individuals here 2 nights ago, right?
The Kingfisher Inn. I could have sworn we saw this exact... No, it said the Midnight something Inn. It just looked really similar.
Is there anyone out here?
There sure isn't. I guess the only thing to do is to go inside.
But let's enter from the top. If that's even possible. Oh, it is.
Start barging into people's rooms. See if there's anything we can reappropriate.
Ooh. There's some fishing rods propped up against the rack. A little sitting area.
This place does seem pretty picturesque. But right now, we have to start interrogating jokers. If we could track down some jokers to interrogate. Oh, here we go.
Talk.
Sophina, welcome to the Kingfisher Inn. Please, let me know if you would like to stay.
Looks like Niall.
Oh, shop! What do you have for me? Deep-fried smelt.
Boiled miso carp. Grilled rainbow. Rockfish skewer. Salmon... Munier.
So I must be able to fish in this game then, because there's no way I can acquire the ingredients for those unless I purchase them.
Annette, my mother and I came here every year on vacation around this time. It's a tradition in our family. My mother seems to look forward to it every year. Or every time, rather. I kind of feel bad for my father, though, as he always gets left behind.
How is it a family tradition if your father gets left behind every time?
Elk, the Kingfisher Inn in Bose and the Maple Leaf Inn in Zeiss are my favorite places to stay.
Maybe? Maybe it's him I gotta talk to? Oh, it is him I have to talk to! Leonard, welcome to the Kingfisher Inn. Are you all here to stay?
Let's see. Yes and no. How should I put it?
We're here looking for a certain someone. Is there a guest staying here who loves to fish?
After talking to a couple people, I really don't feel like that narrows it down.
Well, pretty much everybody who stays here loves to fish.
We heard he was a friend of the old man who stayed here yesterday. Do you have a clue who that might be?
Oh, are you talking about old man Kuano? If you're talking about his fishing buddy, then I think you must mean Lloyd.
Lloyd? I've heard he's a professional angler who came all the way here from the Royal City. It seems as though he's a member of the Fisherman's Guild there. He sounds like a pretty amazing guy. Do you know where we might be able to find him?
He's out dropping a line somewhere, of course. If I remember right, he should be out on the back pier.
Out on the back pier? So Lloyd probably wouldn't appear until we actually talk to him. Oh, here we go. There he is. So we've got Lloyd tracked down, and we're actually going to go ahead, grill him about what's been going on with Kuano and the burglaries. All of that, though, is going to be next time. So definitely join me then for more Trails in the Sky. Bye for now, guys.